With the sales trends of utilities and SUVs dominating the automotive landscape, what do you do as a car maker? Well, you build more utilities and SUVs, and you fit different models in between other models to satisfy everyone's crave for the SUV. This is Honda's latest entry into the mid-size two-row SUV. It's called the Passport. And as Honda claims, this is designed for the adventure seeker in you. At first glance, I like the look of the new Passport. Unlike the three-row Pilot, this design seems more proportional. It definitely has a more rugged look than any of the other Honda SUVs or trucks. All Passports feature rugged-looking black grills, fender, and rocker cladding. This Elite completes the look with black wheels. For off-road fans, the Passport has a 1-inch higher ride height compared to the Pilot. It also has better departure and approach angles. There may be different trims in other markets, but in Canada, we get three trims: the Sport, the EXL, and Touring, and they all come with 20-inch alloy wheels. All Passports are equipped with a power liftgate. You can also get the kick feature on this Touring model, but just squeeze. Now, compared to the Honda Pilot, the rear cargo area is not much different. In fact, it's less than 10% smaller than that larger Pilot. So here, for example, I wanted to show you, we have a mid-size bike and our travel trunk that we travel with. So that's nice and tall. Now this will actually even fit lengthwise up. So that's a good example right there. Also, if you need a little bit more concealed storage, under here is a nice enclosed storage spot. If you want to fold those second row down, there are easy buttons here to just press down and they'll fold down. You also have a 12-volt outlet and more storage area. That's one thing that I've really noticed while having this for the week. There's a lot of storage area. So these little bins here, and there's a small one here. So good to put things that roll around. So otherwise, yeah, lots of room. Put this back however we want. We can go up if we want. And of course, with those second row seats down, you even get a lot more room. Now, if there's not enough room in the back, you can add more storage room up top. This has an optional Honda roof box, and it opens up on either side of the vehicle, which is really handy. There are a couple step points right by the seat, so it makes it easy to get up here. Also, you notice this has optional running boards, and I do have an issue with these. You see, they are not low enough to help you step into the vehicle, yet they're too high, so when you step out, guaranteed they will rub on the back of your leg. And if you're wearing shorts, it's even worse because they're really hard. So to me, they are kind of annoying. So I would probably choose different ones or eliminate them altogether.
We're going to piano class.
We are going to piano class. It's still summer break, so we have the family involved today in the review again. Hello, everybody back there. So we are in the Passport, and the first thing you'll notice is Cynthia is in the back seat. And we like to do that. Well, the girls really like that when there is a vehicle that's big enough to accommodate that. And how is it back there for the second row there, Cynthia?
Lots of room, really spacious. And then the girls, yeah, they got lots of room for their legs room. And then I'm not even squished in the middle here.
Yeah, so the inside of this Passport is very, very wide. This is a mid-size, it's not a compact vehicle, so lots and lots of room. And in fact, if you compare the second row where they're sitting to the second row of the Honda Pilot, this one actually has more room. And you can slide those seats forward and backwards as well. So if you slide them all the way forward, if you don't have anyone back there, you get even more cargo room. So let's talk about the inside first of all. We talked about it's wide.
It's all girls,
It's all girls in the back, exactly. So it's wide, and the front we have the infotainment screen, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto come standard on it. And in behind the steering wheel, you have a digital display, and it has all the pertinent information that you need. And you have two simple gauges on the left and right. Now, I say simple like that because in this day and age when things are so complicated, this is very, very simple looking and very easy to use, but maybe a little too simple, I think. I don't know. What do you think about this, the dash design? Now, all models come with a lot of standard features like heated seats, heated steering wheel, remote start, power sunroof. This Touring adds cooled leather seats as well as wireless charging and a 550-watt 10-speaker system. Of course, like any new vehicle, this has a backup camera. It's a very good camera, I like it. You can change the different modes of it, of kind of different angles. So if you want to kind of have an overhead view of that back bumper, you can. And you can also change it where you have a camera and you have the proximity sensor view as well. But one thing it does not have, Cynthia, what does it not have?
360-degree camera.
Yes, we have come to really, really love a 360 or a bird's eye view camera on new cars. And this isn't equipped with it. This is the top of the line touring model. I think they really should add that into this model. Absolutely. It's so handy for all sorts of instances. In the front, you have these nice captain's chairs type of chairs. You have armrests, a ratcheting armrest. You have power folding mirrors on the outside. The visibility is very good. And it does feel like you're driving something substantial, something quite big. You ride up quite high as well. And the fit and finish and the materials of this Passport are first rate, what you would expect from a Honda. I've had many Hondas and they seem to last forever, the interiors. And I don't think that this is any different. So what's under the hood? It's the same as the Pilot, a 3.5-liter V6. It puts out 280 horsepower. And that goes through a refined 9-speed automatic transmission. Now, in Canada, all Passports come with all-wheel drive. In other markets, it might not be the case. There might be the availability of a front-wheel drive. But here, all-wheel drive, and that's a torque vectoring all-wheel drive system. This type of all-wheel drive system would be perfect for most people, light off-road duty, maybe to the cottage on some gravel roads, or even a little bit rougher stuff. But also especially for snow and ice in our winter months that we have here in Canada. Now, if you need to tow, this Passport will pull up to 5,000 pounds, which is pretty well normal in this class of vehicle. Now, the ride, I have to say, it's quiet in here. It's very, very quiet. This revised transmission is silky, silky smooth. A lot of the times it'll take off in second gear, so it's not very jarring. And they've also tweaked the auto start stop with the transmission to make it even more seamless. So we're coming to a stop here. We'll see. Putting my foot on the throttle, it's very smooth. Taking off from that second gear makes a big difference, especially when you have passengers in the back. Most of the week, I had another vehicle to drive, and Cynthia drove this one the most. Cynthia, what did you like and not like about this vehicle that we haven't talked about yet?
I really like it when, you know, when I ride up high, and then I feel it's a pretty bulky car, I mean, so I feel very safe.
Yeah, and we mentioned that 360 camera or the lack of. So how would you compare this? Like, we have a three-row SUV. Do you think we could survive with a two-row with more room, though?
I think we can definitely do that. And, you know, because most of the time we only have maximum four people, it's actually beneficial for us to have more room, you know, for cargo and then all the gears and stuff we need.
Yeah, so that's where my conflict comes is, before I picked up this Passport, I didn't know a lot about it. I was just thinking, you know, it's a two-row SUV and I'd rather have our three-row. But after having it for a week, I don't know now. You know, it's like, it's almost the same size as a three-row SUV. You lose out on very little, but you gain a lot more style. And that's what I really, really noticed. I was filming the inside today and I had a couple of viewers if you guys are watching, here's a shout out to you. I met you at that Surrey Park. Anyways, and the one gentleman says, wow, I can't believe, you know, I don't like Honda Pilots. This is the best Honda Pilot I've ever seen. And I said, well, maybe because it's not a Honda Pilot. It's a Passport. And so he was shocked and he was blown away because this thing looks really, really good, especially with the black accent, the black wheels, and you know, that roof box does make a big difference too. It makes it look pretty rugged. But yeah, so just recently we also test drove the prototype of the Atlas Cross Sport from Volkswagen. Now what they've done is they've taken their three-row SUV and they've taken the third row out, made it a little sportier, and now it's the Atlas Cross Sport. Now during their research, they said that the number one thing people are concerned about when they're buying their Atlas is what? Passengers. They want lots of passengers. But for two-row SUVs, the number one buying factor is design and style. So if that is what Honda is after too, I think they achieved it with this Passport. So what do you think of this compared to the Pilot or any other SUV? Put your comments down below. Anyways, thanks for watching. See you later.
See you.
If you like the video, hit the thumbs up, and if you want to see more everyday reviews, hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching.